Okay, in this tutorial, we are going to talk about making a lake because having a lake in your scene is really nice. It looks really good. You can add a lot of water features next to it, little cabins and stuff like that. You can add fish, all sorts of stuff. So what we're going to do is we're going to build some basic terrain. We're going to put a lake in, shape it. And then what was really cool actually is you can really sort of make it fancy by sort of changing the time of day and sitting there and enjoying a little bit of time with the sunset. Okay, let's get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open a new project. We're going to just start from scratch. We're going to go to Island Templates, hit blank, hit create. Now, when it creates a brand new project, we're going to be connecting up and putting files into revision control. It's going to make a bunch of files on your hard drive, and bam, you're going to be in looking at a couple of player spawn points. So let's come way out, and I'm just going to zoom all the way out so we can see our land. And we can do this in two stages. We can create the lake first, or we can create the landscape first. Now, I've got a preference to create a lake first, unless I have an idea of how I want to map out my water features first, and then I'll sort of put them in place, build the tram. But let's go into the landscape mode, which is up at the top left. When we do that, we want to make sure we got creative landscape Apollo standard, unless you want something else, like a bunch of rocks or gray or asphalt or something like that. But we're going to go with the default. If your default doesn't show up and something else is in here, just hit this little button here that says reset this property to its default value and you'll get that. Go ahead and hit create. And what it will do is it'll bring in a whole pile of geometry to sit in your scene. And this is all grass. If we zoom in real far, we can see, if you go too far, and there you go. We've got grass just moving around in here. Okay, so now that we've got this sorted out, let's go ahead and create a little bit of terrain. So I'm just sculpting in. I'm going to just make a bit of a valley here. So somewhere where we might come in and let's see. Let's move over a little bit here. And my brush strength is pretty strong, but I think I'm just smooth it out later. All right, just something like that. That we're just going to make a horseshoe with a couple of bigger mountains in the way here. And don't worry, we'll just clean this all up in a little bit. So the entrance is way over there. And we'll actually really enclose this in because what the heck. Okay, so now that we've got this sorted out, we know where our guys are. They're right in the middle somewhere. So just keep track of that. We're going to come down into the center. Actually, I think I'll just bring these up too. So we've got a rocky edge all the way around. Now, what we do now is we head down into our content drawer. And inside of here is going to be all and then your project. And inside of here is going to be another folder called Fortnite. Inside of Fortnite is one called Environment. And inside of Environment, there's one called Water. Inside of Water, there's Island, Lake, Ocean, River, Swimming Pool. So we're just going to bring in a lake for now. And I want to just move around a little bit. I want to put my lake right in the middle here. I'm just going to zoom out a smidge so we can kind of see where we're working. And open up my content drawer again. Grab the lake and just drag it down. It doesn't really matter where you drag it, but it is going to mess with your terrain as soon as you put it down. You have to be cautious of that. So I'm just going to put it there. And you can see how it has really messed up the terrain, which is fine. We can just build that in a little bit later. But it is weird. So what you want to do is grab it. So we'll get out of landscape mode, go into selection mode. Click on our lake, and I'm just going to come down like so with a middle mouse button. And I just want to bring this down a ways, quite a ways. And it's going to move the terrain with it. So move it a little, see where it's at. Move it a little, see where it's at. Going down a little bit further. That's putting my terrain back, which is good. That's what we want. Now, there's another way to create lakes. We're just going to do this one first. I'd say this is a good one to do first because it's going to build up or remove the terrain around it, so you don't have to do it. But we'll do a different lake in the future. So I'm just going to bring it up. We know where our base is for our ground of our world. So this is where our lake's going to go. So you only get to do this one time. So once you select, as far as I found, so once you select off of this like that, and if you select on your lake again, oh, it actually does. But once you start moving other ones around, if I go here and start moving this one, let's move it this way a little bit. We can't move it up or down. Once we go to this one, it doesn't move the whole lake anymore. So once you've set your lake and you've come and you've moved these other points, we'll talk about what these are in just a second. Okay, so that gets set where it is. But we can move it this way and this way on the Y and X. So I actually want this to come more inside here. And I'm just going to, what these are called splines. So this whole thing is called a spline. And on a spline are these points. And these points are something that you can move around. Now, by default, there's only three. But if you right-click anywhere on the spline, put another point there, right-click here, put another point there, right-click here, put another point there. So now we've got a whole pile of splines that we can play with. So I'm just going to move these around like this. And the other thing about them is you've got these handles. And these handles can shift around like this. So say, for example, you want to make sort of a bit of a bay. Like it's got a little bit of, a little bit of an entrance to it, like we'd kind of expect. So the edges kind of go far out and something like that. And the middle kind of comes in. You can do that kind of thing. Let's make it a little bit bigger over here. And it's going to start to blend a little bit nicer into the surrounding terrain as well. And that's the very basics of creating a lake. Some things that you want to think about is not putting it too low and definitely not putting it too high, as I've shown you here. We can zoom in a little bit. We can sort of see what's going on a little bit better. Now, if you want to change, actually, now that I think about it, if you want to change these splines the way they work, you can actually just come over into the details panel for this particular point. So there's another point, here's another point, and they've all got these details in here, and you can change tangent to be linear, so it's sort of a more sharper edge. You can also change it to have a curve clamped, so it becomes quite sharp there. And then a curve custom tangent, which is a little bit more advanced. We're not going to worry about that right now. Okay, so once you've sorted out what you want to do with your tangents, how you want this to look, then there's something like that. And this is actually looking pretty good. I kind of like that idea. I don't know if I want it so far out, though, but that's all right. And then once you've got your lake sort of sorted out, you can come back into landscaping mode and start to build up your terrain again. Now, my brush size is huge. I'm never going to be able to get anything done with this size brush. So I'm just going to bring this all the way down to something really quite small, like 500 or something like that. You can see how the brush is going to just sculpt out something smaller. But I think I want a little bit bigger. So play around with your brush size. Obviously, my fall off is quite big. I think I'm just going to bring that. And my strength 0.3, that's pretty good. So we're just going to come around and organize this edge a little bit nicer. So it doesn't look like it's mimicking the lake nearly as much. Don't worry about it if it looks kind of funny at the moment. It's like, well, what happened there? We're going to flatten and smooth this out in a little bit here. So that's pretty good. I like that. And then we'll come over to the flatten and just flatten out this part in here. And it's just a matter of clicking, a lot of clicking around, just come through here. And then we're going to smooth this last little bit to make it look like there's a path to get up into the lake. Something like that. Yeah. Let's come back down and take a look. Yeah, that's a nice little pathway. And it comes into our little lake that just lives here. And then go ahead and change your time of day to something that's going to give you some really nice colors through here. Maybe the sun's coming up. Or is it going down? Have we got an evening shot? Nighttime shot? Who knows? You can make all kinds of really cinematic sort of looks to it. Sun's just kind of going down, just on the edge of that lake. You can sort of picture yourself just sort of hanging out over here, catching those last rays of sun next to the lake. Or playing Fortnite and shooting people. So that's how you put in a lake, a basic lake. And in the next tutorial, we'll go over how to use a lake in a way that doesn't build up the terrain or take away the terrain. You build up the terrain. So that's a really cool way to do it as well. But this is a nice, easy way to get in a little bit of a bit of water. You can quickly get that done. So that's it for this one. I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.